Good morning, all of you. Welcome back to the maths class. Today we are going to continue with our topic, playing with numbers. Before that, I'm giving you the answers of the questions that I gave you yesterday, so that you can check your answers. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Okay, so this is first question was about the divisibility test that I have already given you. Second question is, the answer is 279 and 702306 are divisible by 9. Rest of the numbers given were not divisible by 9. Third one is 3104, 316 and 3900 are divisible by 4. Then only 3104 is divisible by 8. Okay. And the last question, question number 4, none of the given numbers is divisible by 11. Understand? So, these are the answers of the questions that I gave you yesterday. So, today we will continue our topic. We are done with the divisibility test. The next topic is prime numbers. What are prime numbers? Do you all know what are prime numbers? I suppose you have already studied about them in your earlier classes. But still, let me just tell you what they are. Prime numbers, beta, basically, in very simple words, वो number जो किसी भी table में नहीं आता है, that is prime number. Understand? So, the number which is not divisible by any numbers, that will be a prime number. There is another definition of prime numbers, that will be that the numbers which have got only two factors, that is 1 and the number itself. Such numbers are known as prime numbers, right? When we talked about factors, we discussed that every number has at least two factors, 1 and the number itself, right? So, the numbers which do not have any third factor, which have got only these two factors, that is 1 and the number itself, such numbers are known as prime numbers, okay? So, in your copy, you will write the definition also. Prime numbers are the numbers which have only two factors, that is 1 and the number itself. Do you understand? Such numbers are known as prime numbers. Now, what are twin primes? Twin primes are the numbers which have got a difference of 2 and both of them are prime numbers. Like 3 and 5. What is the difference? 2. And are both of them prime numbers? Yes, they are. So, 3 and 5 will be twin primes. Like 5 and 7. Right? Like 11 and 13. Understand? So, these all are twin primes. Next, we have composite numbers. Twin primes, you will only write the examples which I have given you. Fine, you don't need to write the definition. Composite numbers is the next topic. So, any number which has got more than two factors, or you can say any number which has got three or more factors, right? So any number which has more than two factors is called a composite number. Fine. So any number which will come in any other numbers table except itself, let's say 4. 4 is coming in 2's table also, like 6. 6 is coming in 6 ka, 2 ka table also, 3 ka table also. So these all are composite numbers. Fine. I hope these things are clear. These are basic things which you have already studied, but I am just recapping so that we can brush up our concepts once again. Fine. The next topic is prime factorization. Prime factorization, beta. What is prime factorization? It simply means that I am writing all the prime factors of my given number. Right? If you remember, when we wrote the factors of 12, we wrote 1, then we wrote 2, then we wrote 3, then 4, then 6, and then 12. Remember? So out of these, 4, 6, these all are not prime numbers, right? These all are not prime numbers. So if we write only the prime factors of my given number, then this process is known as prime factorization. So if I'm doing the prime factorization of 12, what will I write? I will write 2 into 2 into 3. So when I am doing the prime factorization, I am only supposed to include the prime numbers as their factors. Understand? So this is prime factorization. This I also showed you how to do it. Okay, but still we'll do it again. So let's say I have to do the prime factorization of 72. How will I do that? First of all, I'll divide it by 2 because I see it's an even number. So the first thing that I'll do is I'll divide it by 2. I get 36 here. Again, I do divide by 2. I get 18 here. Again, 2. I get 9 here. Now, I'll divide by 3. 3. 3. 1. So, 72 will be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Right? So this way I have done the prime factorization of my number 72. Understand? Let's move further. I'm giving you one more example here. Let's do the prime factorization of 338. Okay. I can see it's an even number. So first thing I'll try is 2. After that, 169. Now tell me which number shall I divide it with? You have to think it yourself. Is it divisible by 3? No, it's not. If it is divisible by 4, no. 5, no. 6, no. 7, let's try 7 here. No. 8, no. 9, since it was not divisible by 3, so it will not be divisible by 9 also. 10, no. 11, 12, 13. It will be now divisible by 13. Do you know 13 is also a prime number? Yes. So I will write 338 as 2 into 13 into 13. Understand? This is how we do the prime factorization of the given numbers. Okay. There is some homework which I will give you at the end of the class. Okay. Right now, I'm moving to the next topic, that is common factors. Okay. You all have already studied about HCF and LCM. This is what we are going to learn now. Okay. So, let us consider two numbers, 24 and 56. Okay. I have considered two numbers, 24 and 56. I'll first write down all the factors of 24. I am not writing the prime factors. I am writing all the factors. Okay. Which I told you in the first class. How do we write all the factors? So, for 24, 1, then 2, then 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. I think I should write it like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24. These are the factors of 24, all the factors. Now I will write all the factors of 56. So it's 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, 14. Then we have 28 and 56. Can you see here? I have written both the for both the numbers, I have written all the factors possible, right? Now, I have to see which all are the common factors for both. So, common factors for them are, kaun se hai? 1 hai, 2 hai, then 4 hai, right? Then 8 hai. Is there any other common factor that you can see? No, right? So these all are the common factors for them. Now if I ask you, which is the highest common factor? So out of all these factors, which factor can you see is the highest? It is 8, right? So, what is HCF? HCF is highest common factor, right? So highest common factor for 24 and 56 is 8, right? We can see all the common factors. Then the highest of all the common factors is 8. So HCF for 24 and 56 is 8. So, do you understand what is HCF from here? Can we conclude what is HCF? HCF is basically out of all the common factors given for the numbers, HCF is the highest of them all. Understand? The highest common factor is the greatest of all the possible common factors for the given numbers. Understand? So, now let's see how do we find out HCF. This was one way of finding out the HCF, but you can see it's a tedious way, right? So, HCF one way, this is we can find out by simply the finding out all the factors of for both the numbers, then finding out the common factors, and then we see which is the highest of all the common factors. But there is another way of doing it also, that is called the division method. So, HCF by division method. I'll take the same numbers, 24 and 56, okay? So I'll divide the bigger of the numbers with the smaller one. Okay, I'll divide the bigger of the number by the smaller one. So 24 twos are 48. Yes, 24 twos are 48. Here I get 8 remainder. Now I take 8 as the divisor and 24 will now come inside. Understand? 8 I've taken as a divisor and 24 has come inside to be divided by 8. Now 8 threes are 24. I get 0 remainder. So here is my HCF. Understand? This is how we find out the HCF by the division method. Understand? Let's do one more question. By the same method, it's 120 and 208. Okay, 120 and 208. So 208 will come inside, 120 is coming outside. So 120 into 2 will be 240. So we have to write 1s are 120. I get 88. Now 88 and 120 comes inside. Again 88, 1s are 88. Fine. Again I take 88 inside, right? When I take 88 inside, what do I get? I get 32, 2s are 64 and 32 into 3 is 96. So it will be 32, 2s are 64. I am continuing it here, okay? So when I see here, when we did 88 and then 64 I wrote, since 32 into 2 is 64, what is the remainder which we got? I got 24 as the remainder, right? So here I will take 24 as the divisor and 32 will come inside, right? So 24 ones are 24. What is the remainder now? 8. Now 24 will come inside and 3 is a 24. So this is my HCF. Again, 8 is my HCF for these two numbers. Can you all see that? Fine. So this is how we find out the HCF by the division method. Understand? So we have learned two methods of finding out the HCF. One is the prime factorization method. Sorry, not prime factorization, normal factorization. Factorization method, and the second one is the division method. Okay. So the next topic will be LCM. Okay. But that we will do tomorrow, because if I have already covered so many topics, so I need to give you homework for that, so that you practice all of that, right? So let's just quickly give you some homework for the topics that I have given you. Fine. First question is, list all the prime numbers between, PW is between, okay? So list all the prime numbers between 30 and 70. All the prime numbers between 30 and 70. Question number 2. Write the greatest composite number write the greatest composite number less than 85. Greatest composite number less than 85. Number 3 is name the smallest prime number and composite number. Name the smallest prime number and composite number. Number 4. Find the greatest prime number. Find the greatest prime number which is less than 74. Find the greatest prime number which is less than 74. Question number 5, the last question. Write the prime factorization of 356 and 242. Okay, write the prime factorization of 356 and 242. The last question is, find out the HCF of A 198 and 360, B 144 and 312 and C is 135 and 165. Okay, please take the screenshot. This is your homework. There are these 6 questions which are your homework, which you will do today, and tomorrow we will start our chapter about LCM. Now beta, see, in question number 6 I have given you find out the HCF of all these numbers. So now it depends on you which method do you want to use. You can either use the factorization method or you can use the division method. Okay, division method is also known as the long division method sometimes. In some books, it is also named as the long division method. So, for all these, you can see 1 to 5 are very simple. Question number 6, you will see which method do you want to follow. Do you want to follow the factorization method or do you want to follow the long division or the division method? Fine. So, accordingly, you can do it. I always suggest that use the division method because that is a quicker method, right? And that is like when you go ahead in your higher classes, if you are asked to find out the HCF, you will not keep on writing all the factors and then find out the common factors, and then it's a very long process, right? We should know how to do it quickly. So the division method is my suggestion. However, which method you want to use, you can use that and you can solve these questions. Okay, tomorrow I'll give you the answers for all these questions. If you I don't think you should have any doubts, but you can also try and write in the message box. Vesito, we are, it's not really I'm not committing that we will be able to see that, but yes, we will try. And let's say things get better, then we might meet on the Zoom classes or something. We are thinking about it also. Fine. So, beta, please, till that time, you know the conditions outside are very critical. So, please, all of you, be very safe. Don't go out at all. Right? And even if somebody is going out in your house, please keep on reminding them, okay, that when they come back, they need to change their clothes at once, they need to wash their hands properly, wash their face properly, use the sanitizer at regular intervals, all these things, right? So please, all of you, take care, do this homework, we'll meet tomorrow, and then we'll continue our work, okay? So take care, all of you. Bye.